he was healed of depression. Billy never touched him, never had a word of knowledge. All of a sudden, he jumped up and said, I'm healed, you know. And, you know, and Billy went over to him and said, okay, you know, what are you healed of? And he said, depression, you know. And Billy says, all right, thank the Lord, praise God, you know. And the guy, he started walking away. He goes, no, you don't understand. He said, this has been with me all my life, and it's gone. It's completely gone. But he was touched. And Billy never laid hands on him, but he was in the presence of the Lord. You're in the presence of the Lord tonight. Last time I saw Billy, he was at Hyman at Steve Leidig's church. It was last fall. I heard that he was going to be down there, and the man was away, and so I just kind of rode down the motorcycle and went in. And signs, wonders, and miracles. A lot of healings, you know, he prays for somebody for diabetes. You really don't see the physical manifestation or no, you know. There's one guy there, I don't know if you remember Billy, he was probably in his 50s, and when he was a child, his brother stuck a rat tail comb in his ear and burst his eardrum, and he'd been deaf in that ear since a child. And Billy touched him, and bam, God recreated the eardrum right there on the spot. That is our God. That is our God. That is the God we serve. That is the God whose presence is in here tonight. So step in. Like Gary says, don't be shy. You know, don't be polite getting up here to get prayed for. Okay? If Billy calls out a word of knowledge and it's you, you get up here. Run up here. If not, you're crazy. So ladies and gentlemen, it's with a great honor that I introduce Pastor Billy Burke.
Everybody, how great! Then sings
my soul, my Savior God,
to thee. How great thou art. How great thou art.
How great thou art.
We magnify you, Lord.
Then sings
we magnify
my soul.
You. To thee, how great,
how great thou art, how great thou art.
Every hand up all over the place tonight. Holy Spirit, we thank you. We recognize that we've been handed over to you. Jesus left, he handed us over to you. We trust you. We trust you with everything that we cry out for tonight. And God, we ask you to finish the healings that's already been started here. We're not satisfied with 20%. And we aren't here to get 80%. We're after 100% pain-free. 100% medication free. We're here to have vision restored and hearing restored and the sentence of death canceled. We're here to get every memory that's ever been lost back. All lost memory coming back. Oh God, we thank you for the supernatural. We thank you that you go even beyond our limitation of our own faith. Oh, we thank you tonight. Come on, everyone, say, Holy Ghost, If I've ever needed help, it's right now. If you're going to heal anybody on planet Earth tonight, it has to be me. I thank you, Lord. I receive right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Come on, give him a big thunder of praise. Oh, it's a different sound. Come on, give him a big thunder of praise. Oh! Give somebody a hug and say, boy, tonight's going to be my night. I don't know about yours. Come on, tell them.
I don't like the sound of that.
Hallelujah. That's better. Oh, you may be seated tonight. Hallelujah. How many have ever been in one of our services before? Anybody here? Oh, several. Okay. How many never been in one of our meetings ever? Okay. All right. How many have no idea what I'm talking about? You've never raised your hands in church all your life. We're so glad you made it here because you'll be doing this all night long. It's really important that you become fully persuaded. It's important that you examine exactly where your mind is tonight. We're so often worried about where our faith is, but your thoughts will really locate you. All this singing, if all this singing don't change the way you think, then it doesn't work. Praise is meant to influence and get you to a new mindset. It's not just to stir you. Praise is to really get you focused to the point where, same as the preaching of the word or being in the anointing, seeing miracles. Many of you have seen miracles. You've been in great services. It's to begin to cause a shift to go on the inside of you where you no longer just believe, but you know, and you no longer know, but you're fully persuaded. Where that margin of error of doubt begins to evaporate from your life completely. Because you get healed as a young boy, you got to get healed as a young man. You get healed as a young man, you got to get healed as a middle-aged man. If you get healed as a middle-aged man, you got to get healed in your senior years. It's just, you know, you're never not in need of being healed or whole. The war's not over until you meet him face to face. So we have to be on a perpetual incline of having confidence that God that healed us before is going to heal us again. The God that delivered me yesterday is going to deliver me today. And if need be, deliver me tomorrow. Come on, say today, tomorrow, and forever. My God will deliver me. Come on, give him praise right now. Hurry. Come on, hurry. See, because whatever conclusion you reach is the spirit you'll attract. I pray for a lot of people that want healed, but they've reached the wrong conclusion. That's why Jesus was mad at them in the storm. He wasn't mad because they were afraid. What kind of a God would we have if we went and said, Lord, I'm afraid. There's water in the boat. I'm afraid. It's dark out here. What kind of a Jesus would he be if we couldn't go to him when we're afraid? What he was upset was, is not that they went to him and that they were afraid. It's whenever they said, we're going to die. They reached a conclusion. See, and a lot of times we reach conclusions and we don't realize we've reached a conclusion. And that's why you get prayed and you get slain, but you don't get healed. That's why you get in good meetings, but you never get delivered. It's because inside you've already reached a conclusion that your situation is a little bit harder than somebody else's. Someone asked me one time, how come I can pray for everybody else to get healed, but I can't pray for myself? It's because you don't have grace for yourself. You know yourself too well. You don't know other people that well. And so a lot of times, you know, we reach conclusions that we're still paying for something we did years ago. The drugs, the alcohol, the relationships, the divorce, the abortions. And sometimes we never get flushed of those evil seeds. And when healing gets tough and there's opposition, I mean, that's when God shows up the biggest, is in the darkest period of your life. That's when the miracles magnify their degree of, whenever you're at death's door, you can't get rid of that pain. There's no answer for, your hearing, your vision. There's no answer for your medication and nothing. And I mean, that's when God gets the most glory. But if you've already reached the conclusion that, you're going to be in the wheelchair because bad seed was planted. I prayed for a man in Pittsburgh. He was in a wheelchair 20 years. I said, come on, tonight's your night to walk. He said, oh, no, I didn't know, not tonight. I said, no, this is a miracle service. He said, just pray for me. I said, no, let's pray and then have you walk. He said, no, just don't embarrass me. See, we like music. We like prayer. But a lot of times we're not expecting much on the other end of it. There's a lack of expectation. We've seen more and more people instantly lose weight in our meetings. Their pants are falling off. One lady lost 60 pounds instantly. One lady lost 4 inches instantly. It's a sight to see. Well, it's hard to grasp the supernatural. So I said to the man, I said, come on, I'm going to pray and God's power is going to fall and you'll be able to walk out of this wheelchair. And he said, just don't do that. Just say a prayer. Don't force the issue. See, you challenge faith. You comfort hearts, but you challenge faith. To hear, to see. The greatest miracles we've seen is because we've had to challenge people to go deeper than what they are. You just sang about it earlier. Deeper, deeper, deeper. That means you got to make a decision. All these songs you're singing is to take your thinking deeper, to get you locked in, that somehow, some way, in a moment you may not know, God's going to step into your affairs, and your diabetes is over. Your medication is over. Your cancer is history. Come on, your MS, your cerebral palsy. I said, come on, I'm going to say a prayer. And he said, I said, how about if I just pray and you try and stand? But I can't stand. Well, how about if you try? See, you never know what on the next speck of effort, what's going to happen when you put forth effort. When I was dying of cancer in Catherine Kuhlman, I was taken into a Catherine Kuhlman meeting at 9 years old, the 3 days to live. And I had to wear a patch over my eye because my vision was double. And when Miss Kuhlman, she called me out of the balcony, when I came down, when she touched me, 4 rows of people fell with me. And I was pinned on that marble floor. I felt the power. Never felt anything like that in my life. Scared me. I mean, just scared and plumb scared me. So when I got picked up, I thought, man, what is that? And she said, take that patch off. I said, oh, no, I can't do that. She said, why not? I said, because I have double vision. She said, either you take it off or I'm taking it off. I thought, I'd never seen a preacher like that before in my life. That's what you call a pushy preacher. Come on, somebody. And she said, so I thought, no. So I just flipped the patch up. I just flipped it up like that. And I was amazed that my eyes had straightened out, that my paralysis had left. But had it not been for a voice that was pushing me a little bit. God had to send an angel to get Lot and his family out. They didn't know any better. Come on, let's go. And they tarried, but it took a little Holy Ghost push. And sometimes God's using people to push you to not think the way you're thinking, to not talk the way you're talking, to get more focused, to get more consistent, to think about what you're singing and say, does that really work? So I touched this guy in the head and I said, okay, stand. He said, but I can't. I said, just try. Well, he stood up right away. His legs were shaking away, He said, I don't believe this. I said, I know you don't. I do. He said, his legs are just shaking. I said, come on, try and take a couple steps. He said, but I can't. I said, I know, but just try. He's walking across the front of the church. The whole time he's walking, he's telling Hope, I don't believe this. Hey, I don't believe this. I don't believe this. I said, I know, but just keep trying. At the end of the night, he was walking, pushing the wheelchair out of the church. You say, what was that, a mercy healing? You can't quit. You can't pull out of faith. You can't think that your situation is that much different, and you can't think that you're worse. You can't be a divided kingdom. You've got to be on your own team. You got to realize God don't heal you or me because we're good. He heals us because he's good. Amen. Come on, somebody give God a shout. Come on. Come on. Come on. But see, whatever conclusion you reach, I pray for a lot of people. They come up and they're standing there and they want magic, not a miracle. See, the Bible says you work a miracle. One of the gifts isn't miracles, it's the working of a miracle. Jesus worked miracles. He just didn't do it. He worked them. Go wash in the pool. Why didn't he just heal the guy's eyes? Go wash in the pool. Go fill the pots. Go show yourself that he worked it. Why didn't he just heal the guy on the spot? Because the guy didn't have any expectation. So he had to work it. Put mud. Go to the pool. Now the man's thinking, I can't see because of mud, not because I'm blind. He changed his thinking. He broke the fixation. There's a fixation you get whenever you've had something a long time. Why did he send Naaman into a muddy river with leprosy? Because for just a moment, he got his mind off of his leprosy onto the muddy water. And God broke the fixation. We get fixated with our problems. And even the anointing can't get in there. So God has to take something to break that fixation just so he can get a little foot in the door. And the moment Naaman went from the dirty, went from the leprosy to the dirty water, because if you have leprosy, you're consumed with it, or cancer, or blindness, or deafness, or MS, or Crohn's. We just had a lady completely healed of Parkinson's, real close to Michael J. Fox in Toronto. She came in just all over the place. And, you know, whenever you have these diseases, they consume your thinking. You know, until you really focus on the word, or you focus on your prophecies, or you begin to really use everything that you're doing in church to shift, you know, what you look at every day. I think the internet's a great thing if you're in the right place on the internet. TV's a great tool if you're in the right place on TV. But you're taking stuff in that's either weakening your faith or strengthening your faith. American Idol will not strengthen your faith. Nothing bad against it. It's just soul food. It's not faith food, it's soul food. You need faith food. So in the time of trouble, you know, Hey Jude isn't a devil song. It's a soul song. It won't deliver you in a time of trouble. Secular music isn't necessarily evil. It just feeds the soul. And so whenever you feed your soul more than you feed your spirit, then you're more emotionally admit, but you're not, what? Your faith isn't strong. That's why your faith is God. Man, God's put a faith in you that anything, any snake that gets a hold of you can shake off. We're seeing people healed of late stage Alzheimer's, every kind of cancer you can imagine. We're getting ready to try and work with the Pittsburgh hospitals to start bringing ambulances and bringing people that are comatose in. We're on the verge of, but it all goes back to what you think. It's not at the meeting that you're in tonight. It's not the altar call that you answer. But you got to get that mind shifted into thinking. Well, one lady said to me, she said, I know my Jesus can do anything, Brother Billy. I said, I didn't ask if he can do anything. Anybody knows he can do anything. Can he do your thing? She said, what do you mean? I said, well, she went into that whole thing that a lot of people go into. He made the sun, and he made the moon. He made the whole universe, and that same God. And I said, I'm glad he made the sun and the stars and the moon. Hallelujah for that. But can he straighten out your crooked feet? Because she was on a walker, and she was dragging her one leg. Her one foot was completely twisted. I said, but do you believe that? I know you believe that. Anybody can believe that. But do you believe that? See, we have no trouble believing God can do anything. Where our struggle is, can God do my thing? You don't go down to the restaurant after church and argue whether Jesus raised Lazarus or not. You already believe it. Your problem isn't Bartimaeus or Lazarus. Your problem isn't the Syrophoenician woman. Your problem isn't the 10 lepers in the Bible. That's not your struggle. You believe the stories that you read and the story. We're past that. But where we're stuck is where she was stuck. Do I believe he can do this thing? I know he can do anything. I know he can do everything. I know he did all those Bible people. But can he do it for me? And when I told her that, she dropped her head and began to cry. And she picked her head up and she said, nobody ever told me that before. And she started crying. And I felt bad. I wasn't trying to make her cry. But if you don't come to a place of confrontation, nothing changes. You just go around the same mountain, sing new songs, keep falling. Falling for what? Your blood pressure's still high. You still can't see. You can't taste half the food you eat, and you can't even eat half the food you like to eat. You don't sleep all night. You get up 6 and 7 times a night. Your bladder don't empty. But you know all the great songs. Do you still love me tonight? So you come to get stirred up again. So you get stirred up again. See, the reason you get stirred up is so that it gives you something to work with to begin to shift your... Something's got to happen to shift. If you get slain and you feel God, not a courtesy fall. If you get slain and you really feel the power, or you get a healing, I mean, that's got to affect your thinking. We just had a guy in Miami. They brought him in. His foot was all clubbed and humped over, and he couldn't walk, and he was born deformed, and they put screws into his foot. This was just 2 weeks ago. The foot straightened out, and the screws disappeared. Now, if that don't affect your thinking, I don't know what will. See, that up here, changing your mind is harder than what you think. These songs we sing, I mean, no matter what song it is, when that anointing's on it, the whole purpose of that song is to get you thinking, I can do anything, I can do all things, I can do your thing, and I can do it now. I can start it right now. I can give you it all in one chunk, or I can give it to you over 3 months, or I can give it to you over 24-month program. I got a 60-month program. However you want it, we can accelerate it. We can put it in the slow lane. We can get in the fast lane. We can drive in the grass if you want to. We can get this thing. We can bring this puppy home tonight. Come on, somebody. But when you pray for somebody and you look in their eyes and they've already reached a conclusion, but they're coming for prayer, but they've reached a conclusion. See, whatever you reach, that's the spirit you attract to you. That's the spirit you attract. Now, when we're in some large meetings, you don't have time to really... That night in Pittsburgh, we were at the First Presby Church. That's where I was healed, at that church in downtown with Catherine. But whenever that man that night, I don't know the numbers we had there, you don't have a lot of time to spend with a lot of people to get in there and break thought patterns. You want the music to do that. You want the faith they come with to do that. But a lot of people don't spend all day thinking on the right thing. Come on. They're meditating on the view. Some of you know what it is. That scares me even more. You know what I'm saying? You get that in mind, and you think it's harmless, not knowing that a week or 2 weeks down the road, you're going to need every focus you have to break the cycle of pain. To get that spirit of infirmity out of your body. So you don't become just a full-time churchgoer that never sees the miraculous. You reach a wrong conclusion. That's what happened in the boat. Why are you so afraid? Why are you so... But he went ahead and stopped the storm anyhow. Even though they didn't pass the test, he went ahead and blessed them anyhow. So But what was he so upset about? Because we preachers teach you when you're in trouble, go to Jesus. Well, why would you want to go to Jesus if he's going to yell at you? He's going to yell at you if you already think you're going to die. He's going to be upset and grieve him if you already think that you'll always be on medication. No, God wants you to think that you are going to be the one that got away. You're going to be the one that breaks the odds. You're going to be the only one in your family, the only one in your school, the only one that your people at work ever heard of that don't have to take insulin any longer, that no longer has to be in a wheelchair. We just had a lady in Pittsburgh meeting. She came. She had no gallbladder. The gallbladder was completely removed. She came in, the power of God touched her. She came back the next month, full-grown gallbladder. Test to prove it. Amen. Yeah. Amen. 5 years ago, a lady that worked for George and Laura Bush, she worked in the White House. She came to a meeting we had in Lakeland. She had no stomach. They tied her esophagus to her intestine. And she lived on iced tea and pickle for 2 years. The vinegar and the pickles would kept her alive. She came into a meeting. She was going into chronic organ failure. And she said, Brother Billy, I need a new stomach. I said, amen. You know, and you just, amen, boom. She went down for 45 minutes. That's all longer it took God to grow a new pouch. She went back to the same surgeon and took it out. And he said, I don't quite understand what happened. Where'd you get this? She said, I went to a meeting. He said, what kind of meeting did you go to get this? See, all of those things that you hear, when you hear something here through your church, when you hear something on the 700 Club, anytime you hear, it's not just, oh, wow, hallelujah. It's to push that mind of yours where it's never been and where some of your mind don't want to go. Where do you think Abraham and Sarah got the baby? He had no sperm. She had no egg. So most Christians don't want to think about it. They just say, oh, God. God gave her that. Where do you think the food came from that Jesus multiplied? It has to come from somewhere. There's another realm. Every body part is in that realm. All the food you need is in that realm. Right now, there's people walking around in that realm. They're not under the ground in a casket. They're walking around in another realm with our leader. And there's body parts and there's money. And that's where Abraham got that baby. He called it in from that other realm. If you don't have eggs and you don't have sperm, how do you make a baby? Bible says what? Her womb was dead and his body now dead. And he didn't consider it. Why? Because he knew that he was going to call that baby in from the other realm. That supernatural realm. Whew. You don't have to get excited. I am. And that's where supernatural strength is. That's where supernatural money is. That's where supernatural healing is. Beyond natural. You know, we think holistic medicine is so much better than conventional medicine, and in some cases it is, but what's better than all of that is supernatural. Supernatural. No explanation. There's nothing wrong with you that your faith in God can't. But you're going to have to begin to think a little bit different and use everything that you're experiencing to bring you to a better conclusion than the one you're at. Because you got to get out of that, well, whenever, and he knows, and whatever, and he knows, and, you know, and he knows, and whatever. And you're not putting any pressure on the yoke. The anointing puts pressure on the yoke. Whenever you begin to say now, that puts pressure on the yoke. Today, now. Come on, I want to see better today. I want to hear better tonight. You know. But you've got to think. How do you begin to change your thinking? Well, you got to begin to minister to yourself. You got to catch yourself when you're thinking wrong and think, that's not right. You say, but how do you know it's not the Lord? Well, he don't talk about you dying. He don't talk about you not being able to function. He don't talk about you being poor and destitute and weak. He don't talk about you leaving your family with nothing. That voice, you can figure that voice out pretty easy. He talks about you what? Getting strong, living out your years. He talks about you recovering. He talks about you being the one that breaks the curse in the whole family line. Come on, somebody give God a shout. Come on. And it takes a little bit of work, though. It takes a little bit. That's why the Bible says meditate day and night. Think on these things. If you keep your mind on him, perfect peace he'll give to you. That's why the Bible is so big on the mind factor. Because your thinking sets everything in motion. You can come up here and get touched and get a major touch of God, but if you're not thinking right, then you lose what you get. You've got to reach a better conclusion. You can't say, well, you know, how are you feeling? Not bad for 70. See, already you're factoring your age in on everything. Come on, you still be chasing your wife around the kitchen at 80. Come on, somebody. Still laying hands on her every night. Come on, somebody say something. Getting into body ministry full time. Come on, somebody. Nah, but see, if you begin to think the way Babylon wants you to think, then you begin to have a different level of expectation. And you begin to kill yourself immediately. Man, I'm not thinking correct. It's amazing how you get a pain down here. First thing you think of is cancer. Do you know if you begin to eat properly, you'll begin to have what's called healing pain. If you begin to get rid of candy and sweets and start putting broccoli down there, your organs go into chronic shock. Your lungs says to your kidney, hey, what's this green thing coming down here? Hey, here comes a carrot. I heard about these. I used to read about these things. All of a sudden, your organs begin to hurt, and they begin to tell you, we don't want this. We want the sugar. We don't want this. So your body goes into this detox, it's called. Well, detox means all the poisons going into your bloodstream. Your body's fighting against each other. Your organs are screaming for the anointing. Your organs are screaming. Your mind is screaming for the years that you have left to live out in the fullness of promise and hope instead of despair and where you came from. You know. But you got to get to thinking that God's on your side and he's for you. I didn't know how to prepare for a miracle with cancer, but my grandmother knew how to prepare me. So 4 days before I hit the Catherine Kuhlman meeting, she says, when she touches you, when she touches you, when she touches you, when she touches you. I didn't have a clue what she was talking about. I had never been in a church service where anybody touched me. I wasn't raised in a touchy church. Do you hear me? I wasn't in that kind of church. And she said, when she touches you, when she touches you. That thing, for 4 days, I got so sick of hearing that. Every time I'd eat my food through a straw, or they would soak towels in ice water. And morphine wouldn't even take the pain factor from my body. And she'd say, when she touches you, when she touches you. I didn't want to hear it. What I didn't know was she was preparing me for a miracle. You prepare for Thanksgiving. We know how to do that. We prepare for church. We know how to prepare for church. To prepare for the miraculous requires a whole nother level. That's why Jesus laid over for Lazarus. He'd never raised a dead person yet. It was his cousin. Emotions were involved. He laid over not just to prove that he was dead. He had never done that. So he knew that some greater miracles require a greater level of what? Preparation. Are you with me tonight? But when Catherine's hand started coming towards my head, she said, "What's your name?" And her hand's coming towards my head, I could hear my grandmother's voice. "When she touches you, when she touches you." I'm serious. All I saw was a long, bony hand coming at me. "When she touches you, when she touches you." And man, when that hand hit my head, it was lights out. And that cancer was gone in 30 seconds. Now, because my grandmother had gotten in her own old-fashioned way, she didn't use scripture, she used the word of faith. There's a word of scripture is a word of faith. The word of faith can be any word you speak under the anointing. Rise, get up. Anything under the anointing can be a word of faith. You're going to live. You're not going to die. You're going to go around the world. You're going to be a millionaire. Anything that's under the anointing is a word of faith. And man, whenever that I got up, and that power's going all through me, and I didn't even know years later that I couldn't prepare myself for a miracle. It took someone else to prepare me for a miracle. But as you get older, now you can prepare yourself. That's what the great church here that you're in, and the leadership that you have, the exposure today to the move of God that's in the earth today is absolutely amazing. Don't waste it, though. Don't become a spectator. Don't just enjoy the anointing. You're not here just to play in living water. You're here to get it, catch it, and spread it. You're here to catch fire and cause a fire everywhere you go. But we shouldn't be having depression days. I don't think days. That's because your mind is in the wrong place. "Yeah, but my heart's right." Well, I'm glad you got a good heart. Yay. Yay. You got to get your head right. You get your head and your heart right, you're unstoppable. When you begin to think this too will pass. I mean, it's scary whenever the devil believes your prophecies more than you do. Well, how do you know that? Why do you think you're having so much warfare? He heard what the word was you got. He believes God's going to do that for you more than you do. Now, how weird is that? That the devil believes your prophecies. He sure believed the prophecy about baby Jesus. He sure believed the prophecy about Moses. What happens when the devil starts believing the prophecies? He starts going crazy on your life. You're here to live out your days. You're here to get off medication. You're here to walk among the healed and the strong. Come on, you're here. Come on, somebody help me tonight. We just had a young kid in Colorado, Pueblo, in a big arts theater auditorium. He came up, he had a cornea transplant, and he couldn't even see out of the cornea transplant. Just a young guy, 17, 18 years old. And he came up, and people from the Star Trek movie were there. People in the Star Trek cast came in from the movie. And he came up on the stage, and he says, "You know, yeah, but I had a cornea." See, there's always a reason why yours can't work. Well, the doctor said, "But mine, this kind of cancer." I've heard that for 30 years. Yeah, but the doctor, Pastor Billy, I know that story, but the doctor said this kind of a cancer. See, this kind of a cancer, once it, and it kind of gets in, and it comes back with a vengeance. But this transplant that I had now, see, they put this in there, so, and I'm trying to pray for the guy, the young guy. But this kind of a, Pastor Billy, see, this kind of a transplant, I want to tell you what they did. I don't want to know what they did. Oh, but I want to tell you, I don't want to know what they did. I don't know what they did. I want to know what he's going to do, not what they did. Everybody wants to get you involved in their story. Do you hear me? God's trying to get you involved in the greatest story that's ever been told.
Hallelujah.
Come on. the greatest story that's ever been told. So he's talking away. He's talking away. And just close your eyes. He's just talking away by his eye. Yeah, and they went in there and they put that in and they said that there's a possibility, you know, talking away. I said, okay. He's just talking and talking about what could be, might be, what they put in there. I said, Holy Ghost, just get all over this. He's talking away. I took my hands away. He said, oh my God, it worked. You know, I said, what worked? He said, the cornea transplant. I said, no. No. He couldn't even connect his own dots. He said, yeah, I guess that wouldn't be right, would it? I said, no. You weren't like that when you came in here. He left here saying 2020. See, my point is you got to be careful that you don't buy into there's something so uniquely different about your situation. You know, because after all, you got years in World War II. After all, you had your knee so blown out, they're still looking for the pieces of that knee. Your mind is so fried from drugs, they came right out of Woodstock. They were a special Woodstock brand. You think I'm kidding you? That makes it's a little bit of, you know, that's a little embellishing of what I'm trying to say tonight. But people have their own, because that's what they've been told. Every time I try and get in the water, every time somebody's always stepping on me, I can't get in that water. I want to, you know, I want to, but every time I get in that water, I can't seem to get in that water. Rise, pick up that bed. He didn't want to hear it. He didn't want to hear I can't get in story. He did not want to hear it. When he shows up, all he wants to hear is, yes, sir, whatever you say, I believe, I'm trusting, I'm switching, I'm shifting gears, I'm canceling death, I'm canceling paralysis, I'm ready to go. There has to be a shift up here. I was back in the room listening to your singing, powerful, your band, powerful. There's an anointing on that music. Amen. But that tells me that it should be causing you to shift in your thinking. You should be walking around all day tomorrow. Don't mess with me. I'm going into deeper waters. Hallelujah. Amen. Don't mess with me. What's that mean? That means deeper revelation. That means deeper love. Come on. That means deeper anointing. Amen. That means a deeper favor on my life. That means deeper results from all that I'm putting in. You could preach yourself happy quick. Come on, somebody. You could begin to believe what you're thinking. I walk away from every meeting, not one. I walk away amazed. He's just what he does. I walk away, and I know it's him, and yet I walk away, and I go, how'd you do that? How did you do that? Because so often, he has nothing to work with. Do you know what I mean? How did you do that with nothing?
I'm used to it, Brother Billy. I'm very used to it.
See? Remember, it's not the great faith that you need. It's the grain of a mustard seed that can move mountains. Given God the little bit that you do have can create great, great breakthroughs. But tonight I think my main thought is just make sure that it's not what happens here in the context of the meeting, but where is your thinking throughout the day? What conclusions have you reached? That's the spirit you're attracting. When you reach the conclusion that somehow, some way, that you're on a nanosecond by second breakthrough. I mean, you're ready to slide down the pole, and I mean, you're just ready. You're living on the edge of expectancy. Once you get the anointing in you, whether you have a complete manifestation or not, that anointing is incubating in you and working in there, just moving stuff around. If you live long enough, you'll get healed instantly. You'll get healed gradually. If you live long enough, you'll get healed 100 different ways. And God will begin to show you how in control He is. Hezekiah had boils, and you know, and what happened? They come and put a bunch of figs on there. And a cluster of figs took away the carbuncles. Medicine, supernatural, elders, the gifts. I mean, a myriad of ways, the prayer of faith, a shadow of people, the clothes of another person. My God, we're surrounded and don't even know it. But begin to reach today. Begin to take what you're singing here in this great church. You know, and begin to reach today for something. Don't wait for it to get worse. Only you can put a gauge on how much you need a breakthrough in your life tonight. Doesn't have to be death. Doesn't have to be cancer. Just the quality of your life. Memory loss is horrible. Can't swallow properly is horrible. Can't hear right is even horrible. Can't pick up your grandchildren's isn't fun. Can't throw a ball anymore. Can't eat pizza at all. That's horrible. Come on, somebody. Come on, that is like a curse right there. Come on. And all of a sudden, without even knowing it, you begin to get limited. So the devil begins to take stuff away gradually. And here you are, what? Not even resisting. Start to resist tonight and tomorrow night and for the rest of your life. There's going to be some great miracles happen here tonight. Come on. But I want you to begin with your mind to realize that your thinking plays such a major role in getting that and keeping that. He wasn't mad that they were afraid. That'd be pretty weird if God got mad every time we got afraid. You're out in the boat, it's storming, it's dark. Come on, somebody. And you're kind of, I don't think it's, Kim, what are you afraid of? I don't think that's the way our God is. But the moment you say, we're going to die. I'll never walk again. I'll never do this. You reach a conclusion, and sometimes you can reach a conclusion where He can't even rescue you any longer. Because you've made up your mind. It's not your faith. You've made up your mind. You've made up your mind. We had a guy 99 healed in Puerto Rico. 99 years old. He was sitting on the front row. And I went down to him and I said, I didn't know he was 99. He didn't look 99. I said, how you doing, sir? He had a cane. I saw the cane. I said, how you doing, sir? He said, I need a miracle. I said, what kind of miracle do you need? He said, I got to get rid of this cane. Can't walk without this cane. I said, how old are you, sir? He said, 99. I said, 99? You should want to go to heaven. It's the last time I'll ever say that. He jumped up with that cane and pointed that cane. Listen here, you preacher. When I'm dead, I'll go to heaven. But as long as I'm alive, I want to get healed. Amen. So I had to turn that around pretty quickly. I said, amen. I said, how about that, young people? Here's a guy here, 99, and he's still pressing in. And the Holy Ghost is telling me, don't you ever do that again. I said, you should want to go to heaven. He said, well, when I'm dead, I'll go there. But right now I'm alive. I want to get this healed. That's why, amen, stand up. Boom, touched him. That cane went flying over this way. He's running around. The next year I went back to that church. He was 100. And he brought me handkerchiefs. He said, I'm praying for you, Pastor. I went back the next year. He was 101. He gave me a box of handkerchiefs. He said, I'm praying for you, Pastor Billy. The next year I went back, he was 102. And I'm thinking, oh, my God, this guy's going to outlive me, I think. I don't know. And then the next year he was gone. He went. So he lived 3 years past that moment. But here's a guy here who was saying, I'm 99. He could very easily be justified with a cane. Who's going to criticize a 99-year-old from going down there making sure he's got good balance? Who'd have the nerve, the raw nerve, to say anything? Nobody. But he knew his God had more for him than that. He made up his mind that God had more for him. Come on, somebody help me. It's a personal thing. You can catch germs in church. Cooties do exist in spirit-filled churches. Come on, they do. You're on your own. You got to make up your mind what kind of quality you want. Because there's some people, they hear what I'm saying. You'll go out here to Starbucks after the service and, I don't know. I mean, I heard what he said, but you know. And sometimes and you have your own concoction all fixed for you. That's why you got to be careful who you listen to. That's why people's got to exude what Matthew said and Mark said and Luke said and John said. I don't see your name in there yet. Neither's mine. That's why I have to quote them. You can't make stuff up. Well, I'll tell you how I feel. I don't want to know how you feel. I'm telling you, what do you know? And I'll tell you what I know because of what this book says. This book says what? He's here to change the way you're thinking about your health, about your money. Come on, about your God-given opportunity. About how things are going to pan out for you in the next 6 months to a year. About our economy. Come on, about provision. About supernatural taking care of you. Come on, about everything. My God shall supply. Where'd that food come from that he multiplied? Came from that other realm. Just like when you go to Walmart and you try and get all their vegetables into your refrigerator. It won't work, will it? Why? Walmart vegetables is another realm. It's so much bigger than your little fridge. And that's what it's like going into that supernatural realm. That's where it all comes from. It comes from another realm that you will go to that realm eventually if we're not here for the great catching away. But that's where we draw our strength from and our healing from, that other realm. Amazing. Isn't it amazing? Hands up all over the place tonight. Oh, we give him praise tonight. We give him praise. Give me the lady right there in the back row, ma'am. Right here, you. Come to me quickly. Power of God's all over you. Put your hands up. I thank you, dear Jesus. I give you praise. Inflammation's leaving your whole body. Absolutely amazing. Amazing. All disease begins with inflammation. And from there it goes into the soft tissue. From there it goes into pain. It goes into irritable joints. It goes into just... But inflammation is where it all begins. There's a flushing and a cleansing going through your body. By the Holy Ghost, by the Holy Ghost, by the Holy Ghost. Oh, he's all over you. Is this your wife, sir? Come on up quickly. What's going on with her? What's her condition? What was her condition? What's wrong? What's wrong, Garnett?
I don't know.
Duffy, can I have strings, please? Duff? Can I get strings? Can I get some strings? Thank you, sir. What's that? A little loud. Head to dun. I want something specific. I don't want the overhaul thing. Give me something. What's wrong? You're hearing me okay? Do you have hearing aids? We'll take them out. Give them to the usher right here.
Usher, he can't hear.
Can you help me, Pastor Ann, right?
The power of the Holy Ghost, I give you...
Oh, dear Jesus, the power's on him. I give you praise. The deaf and the dumb, I break its power. The deaf and the dumb. Let him go! Come on, somebody better give God a shout! My God! Get him up here. Come on, don't go away. All the money we're paying you to catch these people, you better do. You get on the job up here. Woo!
Yeah, I hear
it opened up.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
Say hello.
Hello.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I love Jesus.
I love Jesus.
I love my wife.
I love my wife.
I love my church.
I love my church.
Hey!
I love
my What do you think of that? Huh? What do you think of that?
I think that's pretty amazing. I think that's pretty amazing.
See, now you can hear when she says, take out the garbage.
Oh,
honey, give more money in the offering. What'd you say? How are you doing? Amazing. One of the greatest healings you'll ever have is being healed of something you don't know you have. Yeah.
I was really a son. Okay. I have a son that won't even talk to me, and I was believing for his mind.
Wow.
To be healed because there's something wrong. Something's not right.
Master, we praise you for the son. We thank you for the anointing on the mom, on the dad. Their service here at my father's house. God, we now ask you to just move all over that kid. Bring him to his right mind. Let a grace storm come to his house. Woo! How do you think the prodigal came to his right mind? How do you think the prodigal came to his right mind? How's any of us come to our right mind? Him, grace. If I don't get grace, I don't worship. If I don't get grace, I don't repent. If I don't get grace, I don't change my mind. He has to give me everything. He has to give me all the tools to worship him. Just like you give your kids money to buy you a Christmas present. Then you act surprised. Come on. Look what you got, mommy. That's what you got yourself. But you got to act like they got it for you. That's what grace is. It's empowerment to do. It's not the lazy river, it's empowerment. My grace is sufficient not to endure the thorn. My grace is sufficient for you to beat it. See, a lot of things God won't answer your prayer. He wants you to faith it. So Paul was requesting prayer. God said, now my grace is sufficient. I'm giving you grace, what, for your faith to beat it. Come on, say, everything is in prayer. When you speak to a mountain, that's not prayer. Such as I have, give I thee, rise. He didn't pray. He released faith. Sometimes you release faith and sometimes you pray. Paul was trying to pray his way out of that thorn. But what was the answer? My grace is sufficient. Not to keep it, but to beat it. Come on, somebody give God a shout. Come on. Ho! That's the power of the Holy Ghost. My God. Come on up here, young man. Come on. What do you need here tonight?
No, I need some of the world knocked off of me.
Some of the world knocked off of you.
Some of the garbage that's going in.
We've got to get into that word and drive it out. That's why we pray in tongues. That's why we sing worship choruses. That's why we change the way what we take in with our eyes. You reproduce what you look at. That's what the Bible teaches. Your eyes is the window to your soul. You don't lie through your teeth, you lie through your eyes. That's why the evil eye is one of the three things: the flesh, the devil, the evil eye. But what you take in with your eyes, when those cows were looking at speckled sticks, they produced speckled cows. I know a church where they couldn't find any men, and the church was all women. He had one man. I said, put that man on the platform. The women looked at the man and produced men. What you look at, you reproduce. I might have to start getting excited about my own preaching here tonight if you don't straighten out. I saw a sign down in Breezewood. It says, we rent excited people. So I might have to call him tomorrow night. I don't know about this crowd. How's your hearing back there? There's an osteoporosis being healed. Someone with osteoporosis being wonderfully healed by the power. Quickly. Osteoporosis. There's a dyslexia being healed with your reading backwards. That's being healed as well tonight by the power of God. Quickly. Come on. Hurry. Osteoporosis. Where are you? Where's the dyslexia? Come on. Don't be embarrassed. Osteoporosis. Come on. How long you had this, ma'am? How long you had osteoporosis? Several years. Where do you hurt the most?
My back.
How many years have been hurting?
Three or four.
Hurting now?
It just quit a little bit ago.
Somebody got to get a little bit more excited than that. My God. What do you think of that?
Pray it last.
You what?
I hope and pray it last.
Okay, but see, we got to shift that thinking, see? Why would God start something, you know? She's got to begin to take the attitude, what? Man, this is over for good. Gone for good. See, you can't get everything at the altar. The altar's not a cure-all in any meeting. You got to cop an attitude. Healing should give you confidence and boldness. Put the fire back in you. Get you walking with a little swagger. I knew it! Get out of here! See, what you didn't have, you got to get that fire back. Instead of getting pushed around like a pawn on a chessboard. Floating downstream like a dead fish. Come on, somebody. Come on. Limping in the church. How's it going? Oh, you're great. You got to get healed. Come on, we're not here to convalesce. We're here to get healed and whole. We're here to go to the convalescent homes and say, look, you don't have to lose your mind. You don't have to die like this. You don't have to lose your dignity. That's what sickness and suffering does. It's to steal dignity. Vince Lombardi said, even Lombardi said, human exhaustion and weakness makes cowards out of us all. You back down, you become passive. God said, you got to get aggressive with this. Why? Because he wants to put it within sight. Ma'am, are you excited about this? How excited are you? Huh? How excited are you?
Praise God. Hallelujah.
Wow, that is really excited. That is amazing. That almost knocked me right over right there, that excitement. Put your hands up. Is this your husband over here? Huh? That's him? He treats you good? He loves you? You love him? 52 years. Is this your home church? Put your hands up. Put your hands up. Put your hands up. Holy Ghost, I pray these bones, the density of the bones, become strong. and that inflammation of the bones would not come back. Someone being healed in the L4 and the L5. Herniation. There's a herniation of the back. Who is this? God's healing that person right now. Oh my, come quickly, hurry. Two of them by the Holy Ghost. Catch the woman. How long you had this?
20 years.
20 years.
Worked in a coal mine.
Working in the coal mine. In the L4?
Five.
What'd you think when that just was said?
I'm sick of it.
Power of the Holy Ghost! Come on, somebody, give God a shout! Come on, that power! That's the Holy Ghost power! Pick him up! Pick him up! My God! Do something, run! Do something you couldn't do! No pain! No pain! None! In the leg, but none in the back. None in the L4 and the L5. Who's he married to? Right here. You. Come here. What do you think of this?
Woohoo!
Where do you go to church? Huh? You're a pastor. Where? Crossroads. In Ebensburg. Boy, you're going to go back and set your house on fire. Come on, somebody. See, you can't give anybody anything until you get something. You got to quit passing on everybody else's stories and get your own story. That's why they said about Jesus, never a man spoke like him. He never quoted rabbis, he quoted himself. I say unto you, that verily, verily, I say unto you, that verily, verily, I say unto you. We got to get our own stories. They're the ones that can't be refuted. Because you saw the angel. You had gold dust fall on you. You grew molars back up in dry sockets. You had a baby whenever they said you couldn't have a baby. You're not talking about somebody over in the African, Malaysian continent in the Pacific Rim. When you tell the story and they say, well, who's that? And you say, that happened to me. L4, L5 after 20 years. And you're a pastor. Your altars are going to be jam-packed. And the miraculous is going to be normal. Oh! By the Holy Ghost, come on, somebody! 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 Oh, the power's on them. Come on, you better get a little bit excited over there! Oh! My God! My mind is made up. I've made up my mind. So you got to go back and forth and back and forth and back and forth. No, my mind's made up. L4, L5. How long? How long?
20 years.
L5. Hurting now?
Yeah, numbness, tingling, pain.
Numbness and tingling. Mm-hmm. Hurting? Is it hurting right now, though?
Sure.
You're sure? Check it.
I can feel the numbness. Yeah.
Just check the pain, though. Mm-hmm. Check the pain.
Not pain.
No pain.
Nope.
Okay. No pain. Do something you couldn't do for me. Bend down. Do something you couldn't do. No pain.
Yeah.
That's amazing. Huh? Walk back there for me. Walk back there. She's had this 20 years. Walk back there and touch the bench. Come on. No pain. No pain. What do you think of that?
It's awesome. It's the tingling and stuff that's...
I know. I'm aware the tingling is there, but I'm talking the pain is gone.
Yeah.
And the tingling's still there. Okay, I got that. But the pain is gone.
Yes.
Sometimes you got to take a time out of what you're after and acknowledge what he's already done. Now, he knows you want this and that and the rest of that, but sometimes you got to take a time out, get your timbrel out, and say, horse and the rider, thrown into the sea. It's the last time they ever did that. And that's why they died in the wilderness. If they would have kept praising him after the bitter waters, if they would have praised him after the manna came, if they would have praised him after the quail, if they would have praised him after... They had a party, the first parting of the Red Sea, and then they stopped it. They were on track. But we get bored. We get used to it. We take God for granted. Praise him for the cloud the size of a man's hand. The little bit of progress. The whole time I'm talking there, pain's gone, pain's gone. Little tingling, pain's gone. She's on the tingling, I'm on the pain-free. I've had completely blind eyes come open. But people say, yeah, but my back's sore. But can you see? Yeah, but my back's hurt. What about my back? Can you see? Had one guy was mad because he didn't get color. He was completely blind. He said, Billy, everything's black and white. I said, well, talk to him about the color first. He wants to be thanked. So many people get our praise. And where praise is headed is technology. The iPhone gets more praise. The faster our computers are, it gets all the glory. It's headed all for the image of the beast. It's all headed towards modernism. It's captured even the church. It's made a lot of our praise seem old-fashioned. The scarier the movie, the sci-fi, the technical, special effects, and wow, and we got to begin to praise him for progress. Praise him for better. Praise him for no pain. Why? Here's how God operates. He gives you some to see how you handle some money. He gives you some anointing, see how you handle some anointing. He gives you some favor to see how you handle some favor. Because if you're not faithful in some, you won't be faithful in it all. My advice is, if you want the anointing to linger, it comes with gratitude. It comes with it being really impressed with God. I'm excited. Who's that tingling at? Where's the tingling? Huh? Take your tongs off. I need a little bit of soda water or something. Is that regular I will never cease to praise him, Duffy. Come on.
I will never cease to praise him.
Come on, I'll shout it.
I'll shout it while eternity rolls. He touched me. Oh, floods my soul.
Yes, he touched me.
Oh, he touched me.
Just pick your legs up, ma'am. Just pick them up. Put your legs down, up and down. Up and down. Just pick them up, up and down.
The joy that floods my soul.
No pain. No pain, though.
Oh, something.
20 years. 20 years, no pain. L4, L5. How you doing, Pastor? No pain. Come on, Pastor. What?
Actually, I've had this thing in my arm for about 3 months, and it's gone. I mean, I haven't been able to sleep. I haven't been able to sleep on this side. And it.
If you take this back to your church, it'll be like lighter fluid. Do you have dry wood at church or wet wood? What do you have?
Both.
A little bit of both. Just dump this right on the wet and right on the dry. And man, you got a Holy Ghost fire going on down there. Ebensburg. Come on, give God a big shout. Wow. Come on, give him praise tonight. Yes, sir. What's this about? L4, L5.
Since 1965.
There's a hernia disappearing. A man hernia is disappearing. Is actually leaving as I'm speaking. Come, sir, quickly. The power's all over you. Hallelujah.
Right here.
How long you had it?
3 years.
How long?
3 years.
Put your hands up. He's supposed to have surgery in L4 and L5. It's starting to sound like popcorn around here. I'll tell you that right now. Come on, tell your neighbor, things are heating up right now. My God. This thing could break out and go all over the state. Do you understand what could happen here? God has the miracle of happy here tonight, too. You've got to quit thinking you're in a dead-end situation. You're watching people get help that a man can't help them with. Master, I thank you for healing the L4 and the L5. Since 1965, I break this power. I break it in his mind. I break it in his body. Oh, the Holy Ghost on that man. Ooh, dear Jesus. That power of the Holy Ghost on that man. Ooh, dear Jesus. That power of the Holy Ghost on that man. Come on, somebody give God a shout. Don't cover up these men. They're clothed. They're fully clothed. If you lust after a man with fully clothed, my God. I could see if they was showing some skin or something. I'm trying to get them up, and they're trying to cover them up. We're going to run into a problem with this. Got to get a soul patrol up here. Get this guy up here, 1965 guy. Power of God's all over this man. Wow. Well, he can't even stand up. Power's still on him. Oh my God. What's wrong with you? We need a catcher for the catcher. Come on, I need another catcher behind the catcher. Dear Lord. We're three deep already. How do you feel, sir? Huh? Is there any pain back there? None. Come on, church! Come on, church! Come on, 1965!
me. Oh, he touched me. And all the joy that floods my soul.
Woo!
Something
wonderful
happened.
What are we feeling here? Nothing. You don't feel anything. We're talking 40. No, we're talking, yeah, 45, 48, 48? 48 years.
Between L4 and L5 for that long. No disc. It's completely black.
Completely no, vacant. Between L4 and L5. No disc. Well, what are you saying?
That many years I had to wear 3/8 of an inch built up in my heels. I can't walk in my bare feet.
Get your shoes off. Get your shoes off. Come on, go, go, go. My God! Somebody! God, your name is higher. Come on.
Your name is higher.
Come on, than any other.
Than any other. Your name is Jesus. Your name is the Lord.
Come on, your name.
Your name is higher.
Woo. What are you gonna do now? He's gonna take him out. He don't need him. Since 1965. Now, who's with this man? His wife? That's you. How can the glory? How's that car gonna get home tonight? We'll see you parked along the road somewhere, I'll tell you. Just that's amazing. What are you doing now? Come on, church!
Yes,
come on, church!
Yes, yes.
Your name is higher than
any other.
Come on, sing it. Your name.
Your name is Jesus.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Duffy. Duffy, wait. Where did the hernia guy go? What's going on with you? Did you check? Huh?
I'm healed.
No hernia.
I believe I'm healed.
Did you check it?
No, I didn't check it.
You got to check. Yeah, go in the men's room. Yeah. Go. Yeah. 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 See, we do believe here you can get healed with your clothes on. Come on, somebody. We believe that. Just in case there's a newspaper person here tonight. We do believe that. Hallelujah. Come on, you in the white blouse, come to me, ma'am. You and you in the red blouse, come to me, ma'am. Yes, quickly. The power of God's on you. Quickly. Hurry, hurry. What do you need tonight? Quickly, what do you need? Hurry.
I need help
for my
sister.
No, for you. For you.
For me?
For you. For you. What's wrong with your eye? So the muscles are torn and your eye goes, it doesn't ever come back to center, does it?
Yeah.
It never goes, comes back, it stays over there. So whenever you're looking at me now, do you see over here?
No.
Now it's straightened out. It's straight now. It's straight. It's just straightened out.
Okay.
perfectly straight. It's perfect. It's perfect. It's perfect.
Put your hands up. It's going to wander no more. You got a lot of joy in you. You got a lot of happiness in you, a lot of pain as well. And you use the joy to cover the pain. But he's going to heal the pain. And heal the pain. None of us initially get what we signed up for. We all kind of get the Leah deal, you know. We don't get the Rachel deal right away. We sign up and realize we signed up for the wrong thing. But you have such commitment, such moral, such principle, such bedrock value. You respect life and people. There's an unlimited season of favor coming to you. You won't be in debt. You'll be debt free. Completely debt free. Come on, somebody give God a shout. Come on, somebody better give. Come on. Come on. You know, how we doing, sir? Great. What's great mean?
It means it's 85% better.
So you're saying it shrunk?
Yeah, absolutely it shrunk. For the first year, I had it for 3 years, and for the first year, all my family was saying I had to get surgery because I couldn't stand for about more than 20 minutes at a time. And I said, no, God's healing this. I'm trusting God. He's healing it. So, and he's gradually been getting it better. And right now, I still, you have to kind of like adjust it a little bit. So, but it's just about all gone. And I just got a little impatient. I want to see it all gone.
So when you came in here tonight, it's 85% smaller.
It's compared to 3 years ago, it's almost all healed, but there's still just a little bit.
Put your hands up. Master, we praise you for this. We thank you for touching his body. Capture this man. Capture this man. Possess him. Capture his heart. Let him have that heart that David had. As a deer pants after the water, so my soul longeth after thee. Let people feel the love of God around him. Oh, I thank you for his passion. And finish this, Master. Finish it. Finish it. Yes. Quickly. Ma'am, quickly. What's this? What are you here for tonight?
My husband needs a healing. And
what's wrong with him?
My husband has probably a torn rotator.
Is he here? Uh-huh. Will he come up if I call him up? Come on up, sir. You're here for him. I called you up, but you want him. How about you? Talk to me. He said, she said, you have a bad rotator cuff.
I suppose I do. My back hurt, been bothering me real bad for the last couple weeks, you know. And then my shoulder, I got a rotator cuff in my shoulder. It's been bothering for a while.
Heard it.
Yeah.
Hung from a truck. Oh, hanging from a truck. From a big truck. A big truck. 18-wheeler truck.
That's been about 17 years ago.
How long?
About 17 years ago, and they said it wasn't bad enough to operate on, but lately it's been bothering me a good bit.
So when you hold it up, does it hurt?
Yeah, it's got pain in it.
Really? Does it hurt now when you pick it up?
Yes,
right now?
It still hurts a little bit.
Pick it up again? That hurts.
Still a little pain in it, yes.
Where at?
Back for sure.
Okay, just hold it up there a minute. Let me get it around. Right here? Right there? A little bit. Want to help me, Mom? Want to help
me? Yeah, because he can't even
You want him to hug you, right? Master, we give you praise. I thank you for creating new tissue, new sinew. New sinew. You won't need surgery. You won't need pins. You won't need anything. Because you won't have any pain by the Holy Ghost.
Put that mic over here.
He's creating new sinew. You won't feel anything. Come on, somebody give God a shout. Sir, how's your back? Sir, how's your back? Come on. How bad were you, sir?
My shoulder was bad. And now I can touch my nose
now. And you couldn't do that before at all. How long was it like that?
It's been about a couple years, but I go to the VA doctor tomorrow, so I'm anxious for them to see and check it out. I was just waiting for a surgery date.
Well, you know, I yes and no to that. We had a miracle down in Ryan, Georgia. He was a superintendent for the Church of God's all on the East Coast. He brought his daughter. Pastor, you could put a cup of coffee. She had the worst scoliosis I've ever seen. You could put a cup of coffee on her bone the way it was sticking out on this side. It was that twisted. And they brought her to the meeting, and I looked at that, and I said, wow. I said, we need some shifting to go on here with these bones. And she said, yeah. He said, amen, amen. Well, the power hit her. She's under the anointing. When she got up, that's all gone. Now, what? Listen to me very carefully. I'm going to tell you the whole story. That was all gone. I mean, she said, look, no pain, all gone. So she goes back to the doctor. We were there for a couple weeks. She gets x-rays, and they come back with the x-rays. The x-rays showed it wasn't straight, that it was still crooked. The x-rays didn't catch up with the body yet. And it made me think, my God, you know, we've got to be so careful in sending everybody back to get a confirmation from somebody in the natural. Now, where it's life-threatening, yeah, we need to take extra precaution. But sometimes we're sending people back to the slaughterhouse. Because I'm looking at the picture at the altar, and I'm looking at her body straight with no pain, but a bad picture. How many here ever took a bad picture? Let me see. Come on, say, that's not really me. Come on. This was a bad picture. It hadn't caught up with what God did. Oh, I don't know. I'm going to call that Breezewood number tomorrow if you don't straighten out. I'll tell you. That's all I can tell you. I get amazed over things like that. Things like that just simply blow me away. Whenever that supernatural can be so confirmed. Like the stomach that was growing back, the surgeon came out and he put his mask on. He said, you know, I'm watching. I can tell you not that you have a stomach only. I can tell you what you ate this morning. I'm watching your stomach digest your food. And I'm trying to think, I cut that out of her. I mean, when you hear those kind of things, you think, my God, he can do anything. Let these miracles dwarf your thing. Instead of putting a spin on it, well, what about me, and letting it discourage you. Don't let what something good happens discourage you. Let it encourage you. He's no respecter of people. Amen? How long have you had this problem?
For 6 years.
6 years.
They also said I had scoliosis also. I was in the Air Force, and I was in a car wreck before, but I could never, when I get in the service, I had to be on a waiver for my back problems. But thank the Lord, I feel great tonight.
Come on, give God a big shout. Powerful. Awesome, awesome. Come on, I said a Holy Ghost big shout. Get him up here. Wow. Wow. What? It is? No pain. A little bit. I know it's healed by faith. I know that. But I'm saying what you're feeling here, is it different than what it was in the beginning? It's still catching. It's still catching. Yeah. I can see the look on your face. It's still catching. You're going to be here tomorrow night as well?
I can't make it.
Why can't you make it tomorrow night? What do you mean? Cancel work. Take a healing day. Come on, give God a big shout. Come on. You are great. You're the miracle. So great. There is no one else like you. Come on, you know it. There is
no one else like you.
You are
great. You do miracles.
So great. There is no one else
like you.
There's no one.
There is no one
else like you. This couple right here, yellow shirt, orange shirt, or coral shirt. Yeah, you two. I believe you're together, right? Husband and wife? How you doing tonight? What do you need tonight?
Carpal tunnel and issues since I was about 23, and I'm 41 now.
18 years of carpal tunnel. It's going to go tonight. And you, ma'am?
Deafness in my left ear.
Deafness? How much deafness? Can you hear that?
I can hear just a...
Oh, my. So you got a lot of deafness over there. Come on over here, sir. Both of you. Come a little bit closer to me. Put your hands up. There's tremendous favor on you as a couple. Tremendous favor. What you came out of, you're never going to go back to. God has put an angel blocking that, so you don't ever eat of that fruit again. He's burnt the bridge, the point of no return. That's where you are. You're going to serve him with reckless abandonment. Therefore, he will entrust you with more. Get ready for an exciting journey. Not a sentimental journey, but the river rapids. You're about to go down the most exciting season of your life. It's a great time of discovery and definition for both of you. Discovery and the power! The power! Come on, somebody help me. Oh! My God! Whew! There's a lump leaving the breast area. Lady with the lump. The lump is leaving the breast area. Come on, where's the lady with the lump leaving the breast area? Hurry, hurry. Don't wait. Where are you? I know that's a little personal, but... Is that the lady in the yellow coming up? Is that her? No. She just got up because she wanted to say hi. I'm sorry? She's tired of sitting down. That's why she got up. The lump right here. You've had a lump since 93. That's too long to have a lump. Right? You've been checked? What is it? Benign. You have a lump? How long have you had that? Been checked? Benign. You don't know. You're not going to tell me. You'd rather just go. Hands up, both of you. Sue, And her name? Sandy. Every hand up in the whole place. Come on, girls. Come on, guys. Oh, I thank you, dear Jesus. I thank you, dear Jesus, for the Holy Ghost. Oh, the power. The power. The power. A lot of physical healing is released when you forgive, when you let things go, when you just let it go. But I can't. When you let it go. Don't, you're saying you can't, but you're really saying I won't. Make sure your can't is not a won't. Release it. Don't be the victim twice. Better days ahead. Power of God's moving. There's the yeast infection being healed. There's candida being healed by the Holy Ghost. There's a blood hemorrhage being healed tonight. Oh, I thank you, Lord. There's a macular degeneration of the eyes being healed tonight. Give you praise. Let both of these lumps be gone by the Holy Ghost. And the power takes that lump away. Come on, somebody give God a shout. Hey! Come on, somebody give God a shout in this place. Oh! Come on, ma'am. Let this lady up here behind you. How you doing there? What is it? Your grandmother has macular degeneration. You want your grandma to get... Is she here tonight?
No.
You want to send this to her. Where's she at? Hindman.
Yeah.
Right where we were.
Yeah.
What's her name?
Helen.
Holy Ghost for Helen by the power. Oh, that's the Holy Ghost. Bring this lady up right here. The power's all over this. This lady's being healed. She's being delivered right here. She's being delivered. She's being set free. That's the power of God on you. I said that's the power of God all over you. That's the Holy Ghost himself. Come on, if you're going to praise him. If you're going to praise him, you got to do it right. With all of your heart. My God! I mean, we got to get the whistle going. We got to get the shout going, the confetti going. Come on. If the world can party, the church ought to celebrate. Come on. Grandma. You held the rope for grandma. Let's believe that those eyes are going to see significant change. I want to hear about it tomorrow. Bring this woman back up. Well, the power's on this lady right here. She's going under a total... Oh, my God. It's all over you. Give you praise. You'll never be the same. You'll never be the same. What are you looking at? Tell me what you're looking at.
My bones. You don't understand.
Tell me.
21 years ago, I went to a service, and I didn't know who you were. And I didn't believe in this stuff. But... you stopped praying for all those people up there, and you pointed at me in the back row. And you told me to stand in the aisle, and I did. And that moment, you pointed at me and you said, "You are set free from this day forward. Go in the name of Jesus." And I can remember... a scream came out of me, and a ball of fire came out of you, and I swallowed that fire.
Oh, my God.
I'd been in an accident, and my back was all crooked. My spine was crooked. And when I flew backwards, there were no catchers. But you know what? The next day I had my husband check my back, and it was straight.
Oh, my God. Let's check this lump. You don't feel the lump. There's no more lump. Oh, my God. Somebody. Oh, my God.
Jesus, your presence makes me whole. Jesus.
I know we've been here a couple hours. I know. I mean, we didn't even take an offering yet, so hold on. Don't go nowhere yet. But listen to me. When you see these things happening, he is watching your reaction to it. I can't take lumps away. If I could, I'd have a lump taken away ministry or a cancer taken away. Don't. Miss Coleman used to teach us, we don't even have the gifts. They're the gifts of the Holy Ghost. She would say, therefore, he uses me. I don't use him. If I had the gift of healing, I wouldn't be in a church. I'd be in a hospital somewhere. Be careful. All these people have all these gifts, but we need him to move. We need genuine miracles. I just didn't get healed. I'm still healed. This couple here. Oh, do you know that they know each other? Oh, this will go to your church? Ebensburg Church. You're in trouble down at that church. There's a storm coming there, I'll tell you what. Woo! There's a storm coming to that. Ma'am, that lump is gone. How long have you had that lump?
About 4 years.
4 years. Put your hands up. What God said 21 years ago, he says again to you. You're free. You're unwrapped. You used to be free and wrapped, but now you're unwrapped. Get ready. Unwrapped. And there's a joy coming out of you that no one's going to be able to take or to kill or to destroy. Your joy is not going to be on the weather, on your wallet, on your shoes, on your vacation. Your joy is going to be because you've been liberated by the living Lord. Come on, somebody give God a shout. Come on, somebody help me. Help! Hey, that carpal tunnel. How's that carpal tunnel?
Absolutely no pain.
Come on now.
When I was leaning on the floor, usually anything I do in the palms of my hands.
Come on.
I've worked with my hands all my life. And I was leaning on the floor.
Stand up on that chair and tell the people. Hurry up. Come on. Man. Huh?
I'm a little hard of hearing.
You're also cutting in line for some other people here, too. Just walks right up the center and cuts right in line. What are you teaching these people here, Pastor Bill? I'm happy for you. And how's your ear? Come on. Well, I didn't pray for it yet.
How long have you had this like this?
Ever since I was a child.
Since you were a child?
Yes.
Put that mic over here, Pastor.
Holy Ghost, we give you praise. We give you praise. This is not a spirit. There's a deformity here. This is not a spirit. But this ear is going to open. There's a missing piece that God's putting in there. Right! 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 Right now!
Jesus.
Come
on, somebody.
Oh, Jesus. Jesus. Oh, Jesus.
Opened up more. A little bit more. It's opened up. Give God praise. Come on.
Thank you, Master. Did you ever have swimmer's ear where you had water in your ear and it didn't open up the whole way, like all of a sudden, boom, it popped open? That's what's happening here. There was an infection here. Something you had as an infection, it eroded something back in there. It was a missing piece. That's what I was told. That missing piece has been put in there. So that ear is going to be complete.
Yes.
You guys
yes.
coming tomorrow night?
Yes.
All right.
Yes. Yes.
Come on, give God a big shout. Come on. Yes.
Glaucoma, diabetes.
Oh, my God. Glaucoma, diabetes. Tomorrow night, 7 o'clock? Yeah. By the Holy Ghost. Every hand up on the whole place. Come on. Your pastor here, Pastor Bill and Ann, have given me permission to receive an offering from you. I didn't want to take an offering until you saw the ministry. I don't want you to give to me. I want you to give to the work. Give to the fruit. Everything in the church has been so personality driven today. In America, we give to a name and the fruit's no longer with the name. You got to give where there's fruit, soul fruit, healing fruit, transformation fruit. This lady's about to get healed of glaucoma, diabetes. Who's she with?
Yeah.
By the Holy Ghost! Oh. Come on, somebody give God a shout. Come on, give God a... Whoa! Ma'am! My God! Woo! How are you? Are you okay? Are you okay? You look a little wobbly. How's your ears? You can hear better. Turn around. Turn around.
Say hello. I love the Lord.
I love you.
Happy Thanksgiving. Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Blackberry pie.
Oh, thank you.
I said blackberry pie.
Can you hear that better?
I hear it better.
How much better?
75% better.
75% better.
Yeah.
She's 25 miles to healed. Come on, somebody. Come on. Do you understand? I mean, you know, it's just amazing.
I was wearing a hearing aid, but I took it out so I can hear better tonight.
All right, hallelujah.
And that's the whole story. Amazing. Sir, you're here? You're helping or you're here for? Come on over here. What's the matter? You have cancer. What kind of cancer?
Pancreatic.
Pancreatic. What stage? Stage four. Put your hands up, everybody. Let me tell you about pancreatic cancer. It is one of the fastest growing cancers in America. Connected mainly to the diet, to the American diet. We got to get a hold. Brother Hagen, Kenneth E. Hagen, right before he passed away, he said, the one thing I didn't conquer like I wanted to was my food, my diet. With the Monsoros family and the genetically modified food that's in all the restaurants, they've removed all of the good stuff out of the foods in most restaurants. They know most people don't have the money to buy organic food. So you're not getting a lot of the properties that we need to get. We got to take charge of our bodies. There's things that break down our cellular structure. Please take charge. Monitor. Get victory over this. Hey, we all need help with it. Grace of God can help us with it. But we can't be reckless in our laws of nutrition. Remember, this whole curse came because of food. The garden was a curse on food. Food that was forbidden. Power of God's going to come on you, man. Who's with this man? Come, sweetheart, come. Is this your wife? Is this your husband, I mean? Thank you. You go to church here? Where do you go to church? In where? Claysburg? Claysburg. I'm so glad you came tonight. It's going to be a worthwhile trip for you. You're going to feel the anointing for 3 days. I'm going to touch you. You're going to feel the anointing for 3 days. This thing's going to begin to take charge. He's going to give you a lease on life. You hear me? But he's after you, though. You've been running from him, but he's after you. When he gets all of you, you'll get all of him. Okay? Put both your hands up. Holy Ghost, I give you praise. I thank you, Master, for this. I thank you that all this will work together for the good. Let the fire come into them now. Come on, somebody give God a shout. Come on, church. Come on, somebody. My God, you better get with it. Hey, there's more to see, more to do. Just because you know the Bible story about him walking on water, don't think it's easy. If you think it's easy, go home and fill your bathtub up tonight and practice. No, because we know things, we think as we've conquered it. We're going to see things in the church in this hour that we've never seen before. I had a friend who was at the Meltari revival in Indonesia when the water was turned to wine. Get that book, Like a Rushing Mighty Wind. It's an amazing book by Meltari. Where they turned water into wine in Indonesia revival. And I have a friend who was at that revival. He said what never made this book or the papers was they came in boats and they walked on water to go to where the miracle was. There's so much we haven't seen. And the trouble with half the church world is when it begins to happen, they can't handle it. Thank God for a church like this that's getting ready for the glory. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on, say we want it all. Come on, let your glory fall. Got to get hungry for it all. Sir, what are we doing here?
You told me to press in, and I'm pressing in. I'm a diabetic. I've had it about 20 years. And
type 1 or 2?
Type 2. That's weight-related. I know my pancreas still works. because when I start to lose weight, it starts coming down. But I've had problems with my eyes. I've had a lot of laser surgery. But they just told me that the worst I've ever been, and I got to lose 140 pounds. And she said, you better do it now. And I know I have a calling in my life, and I'm tired of this. I got to be healed, and I got to get up and get going, because like you said, it consumes your life.
Yeah, Randy, put your hands up. You'll remember this night. You'll remember this night. Put your hands up. You will remember this night. You'll remember it. It's not by might or power. But boy, whenever you get a hunger, that's all, everything in that Bible is predicated upon what? Hunger and thirst. Not your looks, not who you know, not your age, not your gender, not your status. Hunger. And I sense you're hungry for what God has. Master, I pray for supernatural weight loss. I pray for 30 pounds to fall right away. I pray for 30 more and 30 more after that. God, I pray for supernatural weight loss. Come on, somebody give God a shout. Oh my God. Woo! See, what helps is he's a seeker. When you're a seeker, it changes the dynamics. Yes, sir.
I have prostate cancer. My wife has fibromyalgia. My children have vision difficulties. And I also like some healing in my marriage as well.
What kind of, where's your prostate cancer? What stage?
I had my prostate removed.
Had it removed. Mm-hmm. And the cancer's come back. Put your hands up. Come on, help me tonight, church. Help me tonight. Tomorrow night's going to be powerful. Get here early. I'd like to see about 30 people here by 6:30 to pray. At least 30 people in this auditorium to pray for tomorrow night. I believe we're going to see a glory hit this place tomorrow night. 6:30. How many? 30 people can be here. 30 people tomorrow night. Not the fellowship. I want you here calling on God. Getting this place ready for the Holy Ghost. Master, I thank you for canceling the sentence of death in this man. And grow him a new prostate, I pray. Grow him a new prostate. I pray, God, you get back the organ that was taken out. We've seen kidneys. We've seen stomachs. We've had lungs grow back. We've had appendix grow back. God, grow back this prostate. Grow it back. Extend his life. Touch his family. We put an axe to the root by the Holy Ghost. Oh, come on, somebody give God a shout. Yes. I know you. Don't I know you? Have I met you before? Never met you before. You look very familiar. What do we have here? We have what?
Parkinson's.
Can I have a little soda? I haven't been in so many services, like I said, and my body's a little... That's what I want right here, a little bit of this. Thank you. How long you had Parkinson's?
17 years.
Can you walk without that? No, I just ask if you could. I just ask you a question. You're in pretty bad shape, yeah. Yeah, okay. You've had this for 17 years.
Yes.
You go to church here?
No.
Where do you go to church?
Huntington.
Where?
Huntington.
Huntington. Who's here with you?
My wife.
Your wife? Pretty bad. Pretty big job on you, isn't it? You must love him so much, huh?
Put your hands on my hands.
No, flat. Flat. There comes the power. Get ready, sir. Get ready. You're ready. The lady we just had in Toronto was worse than this. Way worse. These tremors are going to stop. Be loosed! And oh! Get a camera on that.
Glorify thy name.
And we glorify
thy name in all the earth.
Get him up, hurry up. Come on, walk. Walk. Don't think about it. Walk. Walk. Follow him. Walk.
Thy name.
One side's okay, and this side's just, oh, there we go. Yeah. He's healing every part of the brain. He's healing the lesions on the brain. You'll never be this way again. Come here. Come here. Is this amazing or what?
I feel the Spirit on me so greatly, I'm just shaking all over. I can feel the Spirit. Thank you, Jesus.
But how about in him? Have you seen him do this like that?
No.
What's up, Doc? Come on, somebody. Where's the beef? Make my day. Come on, put them all together. What do you have? Healed! Look at me. Look at my eyes. Look at me. Shh. 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 You're okay. You're going to be okay. You're getting your life back. You're getting your life back. You're going to do everything it's planned to do. Mm-hmm. The lady that was healed in Toronto, we've been trying to get Michael J. Fox into a service for years. And here she came. She couldn't even walk. She was shaking so bad, and I didn't know who she was. And after she got healed and ran around the auditorium, she said Michael J. flew his jet into Toronto to meet her and had been giving her his own medication that didn't help her. I said, so you know Michael J. Fox? She said, of course I know Michael J. Fox. Well, see this? What's going to happen tonight and through the night is you're going to do what I'm doing. You're going to get him to put his hand in your hand, okay? You have the tongues? You pray in tongues? You do? Let me hear your tongues. Go ahead. Give me some tongues. Give me some tongues. Give me some tongues.
Ecola. Shuliente ecola.
Okay. Shuliente ecola. You're going to begin to pray in the language that you have all through the night, even when he falls asleep. This is on its final stretch. What he did tonight, he broke a barrier tonight. How do you feel?
My back is killing me.
Your back is killing you. Well, the preacher hasn't had you run up and down the church before. That's why. How do you feel, though? I can see that. I can see that. That's going to go away. That's going to go away. The arm is a symptom. It's the brain that he's healing.
Yeah. All right.
It's the brain that he's healing. It comes from the lesions on the brain. Be loose! I'm telling you, you better cancel all the plans you had for him not having a life. Everything you wanted to do and more is about to happen. Somebody's got to say no. Come on, church. How you feeling? You what? What's that mean?
Two days.
You tell the people again.
I couldn't stand up straight for the last 2 days.
Bloating in his stomach from the cancer.
And how's that doing now? How's that?
It feels a lot better. I'm standing up.
He that believes and does not doubt in his heart. That doubt is worse than, it's a killer. I believe, I believe, I believe. If you got to go to bed, whatever you got to do. But you felt the power. It's what you do with it. And you, come here a minute now. You got to get a hold of yourself. No, I mean it. You got to get a hold of yourself.
I have some issues in my...
You have some issues, I know. But you got to just look to him, not to him. You know, he's got to be your rock. Not your husband. He can't be your rock right now. It's the chance for you to grow deeper in the Lord, okay? If you keep looking to him, you could cut this thing off. You got to look to him. Right? You're complete in him, not him. No man can complete you. No woman can complete me. Marriage don't complete you. It's when you're in him, the tricord, in him. We're complete in him. Baseball career, basketball career, movie star career. You're not complete in anything but him. By the Holy Ghost. You got to get peace before real healing can come. You got to get peace with something. Get peace with it. What's his name? What's your husband's name over here? What's his name? Stephen. Oh, you all know him? He's not in Ebensburg Church, right? I'm wondering what church I'm at tonight. Ebensburg. He's doing good with that hand, isn't he? It's calming down quite a bit, isn't it? You coming tomorrow night? You bringing him tomorrow night? It'd be great if you could just get here. Get him in the atmosphere, okay? Every hand up. Listen to me. I'm going to pray now that you would hear God in your heart. I don't want you giving from your mind. Give from your heart tonight. You know, we're so glad to be here. It's a privilege to be here. But I need you to put a value on what you see here tonight. We're not all in the same place economically. We all can't give the same, but we can sacrifice the same. Your pastor wants this place to continue to be a perpetual feeding ground, proving ground. You got to support that. Support it for the work you saw tonight. Support it for the vision of this church, of your pastor. There's so many reasons why giving tonight and giving what God wants you to give. If you've never given a certain amount before, you're stuck on $20, go past that. If you're stuck on $100, go past that. Break the barrier. Go where you've never been. Do something different. Hands up. I'm going to pray. Father, bless the people tonight. Bless the people tonight as they sow seed into the ground. We thank you for this great church. We thank you for the move. We thank you for the testimonies coming out of this night. But, oh God, bless them tonight. Bless them tonight. Where's the pastor at? Pastor Bill, where'd he go?
Thank you, Lord. Wow. Awesome. Can I have some ushers up here, please? I thank you, Lord, Father. Thank you for being an awesome God and holy, holy are you, Lord. The offering is holy. Holy unto the Lord. It's amazing if I could get offer you a deal, if I would say to you, I'll give you all $1,000. How many over here would like to have $1,000? Miss Fita, you know, if I would make you that deal, I'd say, all right, this is the deal. I'll give you the $1,000 if you'll give me $100 back. That's the same deal God gives us. He blesses us. Just asks us to give part of it back. And so listen to what he's saying to you. Listen to his voice. Father, what would you have us give this night into your kingdom? Into your graciousness and into your love and your mercy, Lord, Father God, that you showed upon us tonight, that you came and touched your people. I ask you, Lord, Father God, that they'd be blessed, that those who give, Lord, Father God, that the spirit of poverty be broken off in Jesus' name, and the abundance of the kingdom of God flow to God's people in Jesus' name. I thank you, Lord, and I praise your holy name. And all the people said, amen. God bless you.